The most recent book of mine to be published in French is Eden Springs, and it's a novella, a short novel. I wrote it after becoming very interested or maybe obsessed with a true story. It's historical, of a cult that was in the town where my father and all of my family lived, and where, you know, where my relatives originally immigrated to from Russia and Germany and Poland. And I had never heard of this cult before. Even I was in my 30s before I ever found out that in this quite small town there had been a large cult of 2,000 people or so, and a very unusual history. And the way I found out was my father and stepmother were talking to each other about this amusement park that they used to go to when they were teenagers. And I had never heard of the amusement park, because all of this had, by the time I was born, it had all fallen to ruin. So I asked them about the amusement park, and that led them to telling me that the amusement park had been begun and was run by a very large cult that had lived in the area for a long time. And then I started to ask more questions and found out that the cult had actually, the amusement park had gone with it, had been brought down or ruined or come to ruin because of a sex scandal. With the guru or the leader of this cult was eventually accused of having been molesting and sleeping with and abusing girls and women in the cult. And so there was a long trial, a lot of transcripts, and lots of testimonies given. But really nothing is much said in the area about this cult any longer. And it was just an accepted part of the community. And in fact, I think what was so compelling to me was that my family had known about it and had been, you know, that the amusement park is a very small place, so having a big amusement park was a big part of their lives, but that it had been run by this cult. And all my life, all of my relatives were aware of this, and no one had ever said a word to me about it. And I think that it was not because they were embarrassed, or, I mean, they were perfectly happy to tell me all about the sex scandal after that, so it wasn't some sort of shame or inhibition. It was just so familiar to them that, and in a small conservative area. So I became very curious and asked more questions, and I asked where was this amusement park, and I expected, because it had been shut down for half a century, that it probably was a shopping mall or a Walmart by now, but instead, it's still there, and there are still a few cult members who live there. And it's, so I asked to go see it, and then they took me to see it, and it's truly a haunted area. It's acres and acres and acres, and also a huge compound where thousands of people lived and no longer do. Mansions standing empty, and all of the amusement park still there but in ruins. The stage collapsed, but still with a sign. So you still even see the little stand where they would have sold tickets to the amusement park, but all grown over with foliage and just, you know, kind of turned into a wasteland and a jungle. And as I said, to me, it just felt very haunted. And after that, I wanted to know everything about what had happened. And not very much has been written about. I mean, there's a couple of, you know, books that have been written, nonfiction books that compile some of the information. But it's such a complicated story that, I mean, I think even writing a scholarly or historical book about it has been hard for people. So I just started reading all the transcripts and going to see the amusement park and asking questions of the few people I met with, some of the people who still live there, and talked to them. And it was, I felt, so the book itself has ended up being a bit of a scrapbook or a collage. I started collecting postcards because it was a tourist attraction. They sold a lot of postcards. I started collecting artifacts and postcards and what newspaper articles I could find, and reading transcripts. And the story is told by all these people who were interviewed after the scandal, and the truth becomes murkier and murkier the more I read, because they all contradict each other. Some say that he was molesting and people, and he was abusive, and he was even accused of murder. And then others are saying at the same time, and often their relatives who are contradicting each other, said that no, he was wonderful. He was like a god to them, and that living there was like living in paradise. And that, I mean, the contrasts between what people say about it are, I mean, it was just very intriguing. So what I wanted to do was make a bit of a pastiche of all those different voices and different experiences, and try to think about what the truth could possibly be. And that's how I wrote Eden Springs. So there are so many different stories. So many people pass through there at different times. And many of the younger girls told the same story. Some told radically different ones. But there were a lot of girls there. And I envisioned the only way I could envision telling that story was to tell all of their stories. And I guess I thought of them as kind of a choir presenting, you know, or singing their experience. So one book I've very recently read by a writer who's here at the festival, Dan Sean, is Ill Will. And he's one of my favorite writers. Anyway, I love his short stories and all of his work. He lives in a state next to mine. We've only met here at this festival, but it's a very scary, dark, strange novel. Many different possibilities for what the truth is of it, and it's, you know, brings in some urban legends, I think, and also, but also feels very real and very, he paints a very frightening picture of a kind of place and landscape that I'm really familiar with because it's close to where I live. So.